those of you that's been following us for the last year, you know that we've been stuck in Australia and we can't get home. But, oh, ik kan het niet omdraaien als je kan aan het filmen. Nou, we have made it back to the Netherlands.
Welcome to me being finally back in Netherlands. So I want to show this map. This is Friesland. This is where it is. This is where the majority of the dialect is spoken. Fries is a language within the Netherlands. It's a recognized language. It's completely different. It has its own grammar rules and vocabulary. So it is a separate language to the Dutch language, yet most of its speakers live within the Netherlands. Within the grouping of Friesian languages, there are three major categories. The first one is North Friesian, and this is spoken in a province within Germany. And is spoken by about 10,000 people on average. The next group of Friesian languages is Saterland Friesian. So this is spoken literally by just a few thousand people in a few very specific villages also in Germany. The group that I want to focus on is called West Friesian, and this is spoken mostly in the Friesian province of the Netherlands, and it's also spoken by my parents-in-law. So I haven't studied the language. I've heard bits and pieces of words. I can say things like omhenje, and that's about as far as my Friesian goes. So the Friesian I want to focus on today is West Friesian. And like mentioned before, this is spoken within the Netherlands in the Friesian province. Within these three major groups of Friesian languages, there are a multiple number of dialects and variations, even from village to village. That is one thing that I have learned massively on this channel, is how many variations and dialects there are within the not only the Dutch language, but also the Friesian language. So all of these variations can come into play as well. I also took an interest to it because I found it really interesting that there weren't that many people that spoke this language, but it was considered its own language within the Netherlands. So I wanted to try something. I want to see if I can understand it. I've never studied it. I don't hear it a lot. I know I said my parents-in-law actually speak it, but they don't speak it when Dutch speakers are around and when we're at home with the family. I guess they speak it with each other occasionally in private. So I don't have much exposure to the Friesian language, and Friesian has a bit more of a history in terms of where it came from and how it's linked with English. Apparently, according to language experts, has a lot of ties to Old English. So my test today is to see what, if with my English brain and my knowledge of Dutch, can I guess what people are saying? Can I actually understand Friesian without ever having really studied the language? Now, I have found a clip of a woman speaking West Friesian on WikiTongues, and I haven't seen it before, so I want to watch it together, and I'm going to try my best to try and maybe translate it or just see if I can understand what she's talking about and what she's saying. So let's jump into it and see if I can understand any of it. Okay, so as far as I know, the video actually does say that it's got English subtitles, so I've got my computer down here and my headphones on so that I can hear the video, and I'm going to try and guess what she's saying and then check myself by reading the English subtitles. So I'm going to start from the start, and I'll pop a recording in the corner so that you guys can see what I'm listening to. All right.
Goeie, ik ben Sjaakje. Ik woon in Friesland, dat is een van de noordelijke provincies van Nederland, en in Friesland praten we Fries.
Okay, so she's basically just introduced herself. Fronje? Was that her name? And she speaks Friesian and lives in Friesland. Is that right? I'm just going to keep listening.
Ik werk je bij de AVOEK in Leeuwarden. En de AVOEK zet hem in voor de promotie van de Friese taal en cultuur in de breedste zin van het woord.
Is een AVOEK like a gemeente, like a council? AVOEK. She's working at the AVOEK? I don't know what the AVOEK is. Or is it the place?
We hebben een specialiseerde boekentaalwinkel of cadeauwinkel in Ljouwert. We zijn wel uit Ljouwerij.
They have a special bookstore. She works in a souvenir store. She must work in some sort of touristy place. AFOC. I really don't know what an AFOC is.
Wij verzorgen allerhande promotiecampagnes over de Friese taal. We hebben hartstikke mooie projecten die met het Fries te krijgen hebben.
They run promotion campaigns. I feel like that's almost basically like English, but I feel like that's probably said very similarly in Dutch, so that's not anything special, but they're running promotion campaigns about the Frisian language. So she actually works for an industry that promotes the Frisian language.
Pikkelen Friestalig lesmateriaal voor basisschool, voor middelbare school. Bij jou cursussen Fries.
She's making the content for primary school and high school to learn Frisian?
We doen dus een heel soort met die Friese taal. En in het jaar 2018, waarin het Ljouwert culturele hartstad is van Europa, hebben we nog een heel speciaal project. En dat is binnen Law van Taal, de Talentuin en het Talenpaviljoen MEM, hier in de Preestertuin in Ljouwert. En in het Talenpaviljoen presenteren we net alleen de Friese taal, maar een heel grote oren Lietse talen. En dat binnen talen en dialecten in Nederland, dat binnen Lietse talen nu.
I feel like I'm getting lost. I'm trying to pick up on bits and pieces. I don't think I'm piecing it together anymore. I feel like the information in the beginning was pretty basic. I'm lost. I don't think I can understand anymore.
Europa, en dat ben ik taal van meerskippen die het investeert leert aan je. Dat is heel nieuwsgierig. Heel talig, van meestal niet een nieuwsgierig naar binnen.
Nieuwsgierig? Nieuwsgierig van binnen?
Kom vooral langs. Welkom in Friesland.
Welkom in Friesland. Dat. Oh, that's it. That's it. I feel like the beginning of that was really simple and very like Dutch. And there was a few words that obviously are the same, but some of the really key verbs and stuff were completely different. So I don't think I picked up on them. I don't understand like what her role is with the Frisian language. Is she the teacher of the course, like the course, or yeah, I'm not entirely sure. Maybe I can like watch this again with the English subtitles and see where I went wrong. Sjaukje. Okay, her name's Sjaukje. Okay, so the AFOC is the name of the company, not like a specific job that she has, but the AFOC is the name of the company and their job is to promote the Frisian language. Okay, I feel like promoting the Frisian language, like she works with the language, that was pretty, I got that right. Okay, so I feel like, yeah, I was on the right point. They like make promotion stuff and they're like the promoters of the Frisian language and they provide all the course materials to primary schools and high schools, but she's not the one actually teaching it. She just works for the company that promotes it. Okay, so they were running an event on the Frisian language, but also other minority languages. And there was like a few different events in Leeuwarden and when that occurred. Nieuwsgierig. Interesting. Nieuwsgierig. Nieuwsgierig. Talig. Nieuwsgierig. Welcome to Friesland. Nice. I was not completely off. So I feel like it definitely sounds way more like Dutch than English than what I've read. When all these language experts are saying, oh, it's really similar to Old English, or like it's based off Old English and there's more links between English, and people say, oh, the language that is the most like English is Frisian. If I didn't know Dutch, there's no way I would have understood that no way. So many of the words are Dutch words. There's no way I would have understood that without knowing Dutch. So I don't know how much it actually is really like English. I don't think that if you were speaking English and you like come across someone that was speaking Frisian and you would be able to understand each other, no way. Well, I guess I can kind of understand Frisian then. I would say that that's kind of like a semi-success. Although I feel like when I visit my partner's grandparents and they all speak Frisian with each other, I literally have no idea what they're saying. And the only reason I know that they're speaking Frisian is because it sounds like Dutch, but I can't understand it. And it kind of like turns into a little bit of a like sing-songy. It has a different tone than what I think standard Dutch does for me. So that was my experiment. I'm going to say, yes, I can understand it if I listen hard enough, but I don't understand everything. So now that we are in the Netherlands, we are currently hunting for an apartment and we are not going back to Amsterdam. It's far too expensive. So new places to discover within the Netherlands, and we are so happy to be back, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye.